Hello. So my name is Nina Marente, and I am a paraprofessional currently at Berkeley Unified School District. I work in an inclusion program for elementary students. And Kathleen asked me to do a PBIS presentation because before I used to work in Oakland Unified as an SDC teacher and a resource specialist. And for a couple of years, I was a part of my school's PBIS team. And that was a lot of fun. And then I even got to go to a PBIS conference, which was in Oregon. And like they actually flew a couple of us teachers who were learning about PBIS to this conference. And it was just a really amazing experience. And you got to learn a lot of classroom techniques from teachers, principals, professors. So it's just a really cool experience. So I'm just going to go ahead and share my screen and let you guys know what I've learned about PBIS and why it's so cool. So I like to call this my PBIS notebook because it's like where I have all my ideas, because PBIS is kind of just, well, I'll tell you what it isn't. It's not curriculum, it's not a program, or it's an intervention, but kind of like, you know, a bunch of things put together so that it makes a system to build school culture and community. And I'll let you know kind of like what a system means. It's a set of expectations and procedures that's like personalized by the school faculty, students, and parents. And what I mean when I said I was on a PBIS team, I was actually in a team where we started in year zero, and then I went through year one with that school as well. So year zero is actually a lot of planning, and eventually you have to present to your school faculty and then they have to vote on it. So PBIS is also a way to reinforce and recognize positive behavior for students, parents, and staff. And this is a good thing. It's a lot of fun, and it's making sure that school is a safe, comfortable, and fun place to be. So its roots, PBIS comes from a little bit of ABA applied behavior analysis, because we want to recognize positive behavior. We want to use good language for the students, and we don't want to have any nonsense in our classroom, right? So we want to be really straightforward, direct, and clear with our students when it comes to our expectations for behavior. An example of that is the 5-to-1 positive reinforcement ratio. And that's where we want to give 5 compliments, positive compliments to our students, to the 1 corrective action that we want to do. So we don't want to say, don't do this, don't do that. We want to say, I like how you're doing that. I see how that person is. So we're recognizing students that are doing a good job. I think PBIS also comes from just the best intervention ever, positive relationship building. I think PBIS is that person who's standing there at the door every morning, saying hello to the students, learning their names, and making students feel like they want to come to school every day. So why do we do PBIS? Well, like, go ahead and take a minute to think, what inequities do you see in your school that PBIS would help? Are schools being positive enough with our students, or are they mostly being punitive? I think in Oakland, we wanted to implement PBIS in our schools because a lot of Black boys and girls were getting suspended, more people of color were getting suspended, and those proportions are really high. And so we want to find ways to reinforce positive behavior so that students know when they're doing a good job and they don't feel the need to act out because there is no incentives for them. And so here is an example of how teachers have to plan in year zero ways for everyone to respond in the same way to students so that students and teachers alike know how you're supposed to behave in the school. And so this is something that the teachers have to create, is how we're going to respond to negative behavior. What is warning number one? How to react to a second warning? How to react to a third warning? Because oftentimes teachers just wanna send our kiddos to the office. But you can't do that anymore. There are other interventions that need to be put in place. And so sometimes PBIS can be really controversial among staff, because once it kicks in, staff get really frustrated that they can't send their kiddos to the office anymore. But it's not all bad. PBIS is a way for you to get creative. This is a way to connect with our students. Am I right? So implementing PBIS helps create systems and opportunities for professional development. And so I think that implementing PBIS, going to a conference, doing a PD of something that teachers can do in their classroom, things that teachers can do with their students, that's good. That helps them grow, and it like makes them feel good about being in their classroom again. And hopefully it also lets you know that you do have control over like the climate in your classroom and how you want to do it. And so it's imperative that staff is well-informed, trained, and a majority vote in favor of PBIS in the school. And I really do mean that. When I worked in my school, we were in year one, we had to do a presentation, the faculty had a vote, and if we didn't get like 95% approval, we could not do PBIS and all that work was gone. But fortunately, they voted positively and the whole faculty wanted it. And so usually that's how, hopefully, it goes. Here's another thing that the faculty really needs to agree upon, and it's a lot harder than you would think. And pardon me, this focus in the elementary classroom. So if you're kind of running like an inclusion school, students are going between, students are going between classes. So you wanna like make sure that teachers are communicating about how the kiddo's day is going. So maybe you could say like, oh, I think the student's in like the blue zone. I think maybe they need to like think about it. Maybe you wanna check in with them. So sometimes teachers won't like that. They already have a system in their classroom and they don't want to make a clip up and clip down chart, but PBIS is a way to get everybody on the same page so that students can see that sign in all the teachers' classroom. And so now I'm going to walk you through how to teach expectations through lesson plans. And this is what you plan in that year zero of PBIS. This is the language that the faculty all agrees upon when educating the students on positive school behavior, right? So first off, you have to agree that you like be safe, be respectful, and be responsible. That's the one that I use, like I've seen very often in schools. So when you're planning this, you have to lay it out. How do you be safe in the hallway? How do you be respectful? How do you be responsible? And notice that it's all positive language. There's no, don't do this, don't do that. And then at the end, it says, how do you do it? That's like actually figuring out the procedure, right? How are you in the hallway? You gotta stay in line. Maybe that there are like arrows painted on the floor. So you have to teach that to the students so that it's not very chaotic. Here is a little lesson plan for expectations in the cafeteria. This is also another place where you would need to plan out procedures so that students know how to throw away their food, how to get their food, how to know where they sit, because if you don't tell them that, there's going to be behavior. Here is the restroom, and this picture here is actually from the school I work at, and they have it like painted on the walls: go, flush, wash, exit. And that's a PBIS practice, just like painted on the wall. And I know a lot of schools that said that they would do it, but they didn't do it. And it's really important just to go for it. Here is a lesson plan for the office. And so these lesson plans, you want to like bring them up and teach the kiddos this throughout the year. Maybe you need it after Christmas break, a refresher, or maybe behavior is going down the last month of school because kids are starting to feel weird, right? So teaching expectations through lesson plans can be done through like a school walkthrough, maybe an assembly or something, but you know, make it fun. Here is lesson plans on the playground, and those need to be well thought out as well. You can have like choice wheels out on the playground. You can have these lines painted so that students know which ways to walk, where to line up for certain games, which areas are designated for certain games. So those are things that really need to be like planned out, because if kids don't know what to do, or if they don't have like equipment to play with, or the equipment's not out, you're gonna get behavior. So in the school that I teach at, they use the 12 tools lesson box. And that's just like one component that you can use to assist your PBIS in the school. So during like assemblies, the principal will often say, we're using our breathing tool, we're using our patience tool, our empathy tool. And so like often teaching these things to our kiddos are good strategies that they can put in their pocket for when they need them. And also, I want to say that there is classroom expectations, and hopefully the teachers can agree upon those as well. Because when you write those down, it's hard for all of them to agree upon what they want to see in their classroom. So that's what I mean by like, PBIS is a very personalized system. Here's another thing you can personalize is your noise levels. I like the little Pac-Man. You know, what is a level one? What is a level two? What is a level zero? And generally, you can also relate your PBIS theme to your school mascot. So I worked for one school, we were like the Panthers. So we had like paws. We had like paws tickets, and everything was done through PAWS so that students and teachers can remember the system very well. And this is a matrix, and that's what the teachers plan in that year zero. It's just like a literal like page for everyone, you know, new staff members, substitute teachers, parents and students, you know, for everyone to be on the same page of how we're respectful, responsible, and safe in different areas of the school. Generally for PBIS, we like to give out tickets so that students know when they're doing a good job. And it usually turns into like a fun raffle or like a banking system where students can like purchase things from a store. You can already think that that might be like hard to do, and it is. Someone's gotta make those tickets. The kiddo's gotta hold them. You gotta fill them out. Every time you're like giving a student one for a good deed. And it is hard, but that's what you're committing to as a faculty. And if you're consistent with it, it works. So when I went to the PBIS conference, there were different things that you can do in your classroom to really make sure that students are doing their best. And they were all very creative ways for students to really like self-evaluate themselves. So I actually learned from one elementary school teacher. She did a seminar on how to teach your students to manage their own goal books, how to write them, how to check them off. And then she provided us examples of her students' goal books, which was really cool. So that's just one example of like ways to incorporate PBIS into your practice to make sure that your classroom is a really vibrant community. Another way to really enliven your school community is to do an attendance program. And I also know that a lot of schools implement PBIS because they're having attendance problems. So I like these bulletin boards. You know, someone makes them and it gives students an idea of how they're doing in attendance and also like what their goal is, because many students don't know how many days they have to come to school. Many students don't know that it's important to come every day. I think that students have to come like 94.67% of the time to like reach a good goal. And that's a lot of days of school. So, you know, like knowledge is power. The more the students know that it's important to go to school, I think they will. And hopefully that culture carries on to their parents as well. And PBIS is also a way to celebrate attendance. So if these kiddos end up on this board, maybe there's a party. Or maybe they get a positive phone call home. So here's some other ideas of people using PBIS in creative ways. We have the music video done by a high school, and I'll show you this one done by this high school. Very dramatic.
I need you to stop! I said stop! Oh! There's gotta be a better way. Wait.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the Rider 5.
Three, four, five, everybody in the school, so come on, let's ride to the classroom on the corner. The kids say they just want to talk, but I really don't want to raise my voice like I did last week. I must stay calm, because that's so mean. I'm like...
So that's just a little example of a fun video that teaches expectations, but also celebrates students and lets them have a lot of fun. It's also a good way for the school to let the community and their parents know that they're doing this work and that it's always good to get support. So it's been kind of weird talking about school-wide expectations given that we're not going to school these days. I know a lot of us, you know, we're sheltering right now and we're wondering, how could PBIS be implemented on Zoom? And I don't know the answer. I know that my principal is still doing celebratory assemblies, like Zoom webinars during the holidays during Halloween and the beginning of school. So just ways of bringing the community together is all we can really do right now. Here's a fun example. It's called a confetti canyon. And this is something that you can like download. And if you click on it, actual like confetti pops up on your screen. And I think that that's a way to like make the kiddos smile. And if we're thinking about it, you know, we want to make our kiddos smile, right? So I think here's one last resource. It's called PBIS pop-up parties. So you could have students who had good attendance. They could have maybe like some staff members come in and surprise them with like snacks or a dance party or something. And so that's what I mean, is just that like PBIS is a really good way to let the kids know that school is a fun place and that we really like value them and that we love them, right? So that's my presentation. I hope you guys liked it. Let me share that confetti popper with you. One second. You can go like this. Boom. Cool. Boom. Cool. Okay. Thanks, you guys. Bye.